Hello, this is Matthias Müller for mamoworld.com and welcome to the fifth class of our After Effects Expressions course. In the previous classes of this course, whenever we applied expressions to the position of a layer, we separated dimensions, such that we could apply the expression to only the X position or only the Y position. This simplifies things a bit, since then each expression only needs to compute a single number, whereas without separating dimensions, a single expression must calculate both the x and the y value, or, for 3D layers, even the x, y and z value. The simplest expression that you can use for a single value is a simple number, so 100 just means please use the value 100 on all frames. For 2D and 3D properties, you need to write the values in square brackets and separate them by commas. So, in square brackets 100, 50 means please use 100 as the x value and 50 as a y value. Note that inside the square brackets you cannot just enter numbers but any formulas you want. In class 3 you learned that this comp.width divided by 2 gives us the x value of the middle of the composition. Now to center a layer both horizontally and vertically we use this comp.width divided by 2 for the x value and this comp.height divided by 2 for the y value. So you can really think about expressions for 2D or 3D values as a list of several expressions. The proper technical term for those lists is JavaScript arrays. In the last class, you already learned that you can create your own custom variables to make the code more readable. And for 2D and 3D values, this makes even more sense. The lists of formulas become very hard to read very quickly. So, whenever you need to write such an expression, it is a good idea to create one variable x and one variable y that describe how the x and y value are computed. Then, inside the square brackets, you don't need to put any complex formulas, but only the variables x and y. So, this expression and this expression are exactly identical. But in this variant, it is much more clear which part of the code computes the x value and which one computes the y value. Let's make sure again that you exactly understand what this code means. X and Y are just names for variables, and you can use really any name here. And after the equality symbol, you put the formula with which the value for this variable should be computed. Make sure you don't forget to add a semicolon at the end. The end result of the expression is always computed by the last command. Here, this command is very simple and just says, please use the value of the variable x as our x result and the value of the variable y as our y result. One important thing to understand about variables is that they are not shared between the expressions of your project. So if you create a variable in one expression, you can access its value only within this one expression and not from any other expressions in your project. In other words, this also means that if you create a variable with name x here, you don't need to bother if any other expression in your project also has a variable x, because each of those expressions has their own x variable, and After Effects keeps them cleanly separated. Let's take a look at some practical examples and have some fun with a pick whip. Here we've got four layers, one for each of the corners, and we apply some expressions such that when we move the top left or the bottom right corner, the other two corners follow automatically. So, for the top right corner layer, we add an expression to the position and create two variables x and y. Now, in x direction, the top right corner should follow the bottom right corner. So we make sure the cursor is located here after the equality sign, and then we pick whip to the x position of the bottom right corner. Again, make sure to add a semicolon at the end of the command. Then we move the cursor to the place where we want to insert the y value and pick whip to the y position of the top left corner, because the top right corner should have always the same height as the top left corner. Again, we add a semicolon after the command, and as final command, we add in square brackets x, y. For the bottom left corner, the expression is identical, except that this time for the x value, we pick whip to the top left corner, and for the y value, we pick whip to the bottom right. Now you can see that if you move one corner, the other ones follow automatically. The second example is similar, but still a bit different. Here, we want the two lines to follow our layer in the center, but each of them follows in only one direction. So the line at the top moves only in x direction, and the line at the left only moves in y direction. Let's start with a line at the top. We can copy and paste the code from the previous example, since the pattern with the two variables x and y is the same. As x value, as before, we simply pick whip to the x value of the layer that we want to follow. Now as y value, we essentially want to say, please just use my own value and don't change it at all. We can also do this with a pick whip, by simply pick whipping to our own y position. So you can even pick whip to the property for which we currently write the expression, and it will give us the value that the property had before the expression was applied, or that it has again when the expression is disabled. As you can see, the line follows the layer in x direction, but keeps its own y position. You can still move it up and down manually if you want. Instead of pick whipping to your own value, you can also use the predefined variable value, which exists inside of each expression automatically, and it denotes the value that the property had before the expression was applied. The problem is that the value denotes the value of the entire property, including the x and the y component. But we only need the y component. To get the y component only, we append in square brackets 1. You might wonder why we use a 1 and not a 2. But this is because programmers usually start counting with 0, and hence in expressions the x value is obtained by value in square brackets 0 and the y value with value in square brackets 1. Also note that the square brackets here and the square brackets here have a very different meaning. In x, y, we use the square brackets to create a value with several components. In value square brackets 1, the value is already a value with several components, and by adding the number in square brackets, we tell After Effects to pick just one of the values of this array. So square brackets are used both to create arrays and to access individual components of arrays. The pick whip does this automatically for us when we pick whip to the x or y value. To see this, let's first pick whip to the position property. And in the next line, we pick whip to only the x value of the position. As you can see, the generated code is identical in both cases, except that in the second one, the square bracket 0 is appended, because we don't want the entire value here, but only the first component, namely the x component of it. Let's summarize what we've learned today. If you want to create an expression for a 2D or 3D property, you need to create a value with several components, and these values are called arrays. If you want to access an individual component of an existing array, you simply append the number of the component in square brackets. When you create arrays, the expressions usually become much more readable if you create a variable for each individual component. Here is a little extra tip. If you like the linking expressions we did today, but don't want to write your own expressions code, our tool iExpressions contains an entire linking bundle with lots of different linking expressions with intuitive interfaces. Those also support advanced features like time-delayed links, for example. That's the end of this class. If you can't wait to see the next one, please subscribe to our newsletter, because in the newsletter we already share the tutorials before you can find them on YouTube or on our website. Again, this is Matthias Möhl for mamoworld.com. See you next time.